Hello dear students, we are proceeding with the second chapter, Sectors of Indian Economy, Economics, Chapter 2, your class 10th. Now, this is the place where we had stopped the video yesterday, where we were talking about the shares of sectors in employment. What is the percentage? So, children, you can see the contrast that is there. The contrast what I am talking about is, children, that the sectors have increased. I mean tertiary sector, look at the boom, look at the increase in the tertiary sector in 2013 and 2014, but just see the number of people who are employed in the tertiary sector. 27% of people are only employed here. अभी भी मैक्सिमम पीपल आर देयर इन द प्राइमरी सेक्टर. नाउ यू माइट बी वंडरिंग, चिल्ड्रन, व्हाई दिस इज सो. दिस इज सो बिकॉज दैट्स द ओनली सेक्टर वेयर इवन इफ यू आर नॉट वेरी वेल एजुकेटेड और इफ यू आर नॉट हैविंग अ प्रॉपर एजुकेशन, यू कैन हैव एन अर्निंग. आप अपनी जिंदगी आराम से चला सकते हो बिकॉज यू डोंट हैव टू थिंक अबाउट योर सर्टिफिकेट्स, योर इंटरव्यू एंड A lot of things are involved in going and working in the tertiary sector. That is the reason that tertiary sector is facing less of employment. Okay, children. Now, just see, that is the question that is mentioned here. Here only we are stopping. Why didn't a similar shift out of primary sector happen in case of employment? It is because not enough jobs were created in the secondary and the tertiary sectors. Sectors have increased. Secondary sector and tertiary sector have increased to a good number, but the involvement of people is more in the primary sector. Okay? Because just see, it is mentioned here that even through industrial, though industrial output or production of goods, abhi kya hai ki in the secondary sector, the industries that are established, the production of goods have went up by more than 9 times. When we see the calculations that is mentioned there in the graph, you will understand that the production of goods have gone up by more than 9 times during this period. And employment in the industry went up by around 3 times. Now just see, production have increased 9 times, but employment have increased only 3 times. So the same thing applies to the tertiary sector, that production in service rose by 14 times, employment rose by 5 times. Got it? Abhi yahan pe one thing that you need to understand is, children, ki लोग क्या कर रहे हैं इन द टर्शरी एंड इन द सेकेंडरी सेक्टर्स, दैट दे आर टेकिंग मोर वर्क फ्रॉम लेस पीपल. काम जो करा रहे हैं, व्हाई आर दे डूइंग सो? यस चिल्ड्रन, देयर इज रीजन फॉर दैट. दे आर डूइंग सो दैट दे कैन सेव देयर, दे कैन, दे डोंट हैव टू स्पेंड मच ऑन गिविंग सैलरी टू द एम्प्लॉयज. गॉट इट? सो दिस इज द रीजन that employment is not increasing. The sectors have increased, output has increased, but employment is not increasing in that manner. So what happens? More than half of the workers in the country are working in the primary sector still, because the graph that we have seen, it was showing 45% of people are involved. 45, it's a big number, children, isn't it? So 45% of people, when are involved in the primary sector, that in itself is explaining the rate of employment in the secondary and the tertiary sectors, mainly in the agriculture, producing only a quarter of the GDP. GDP means 100 may say only 25% of contribution is there by the primary sector. In contrast, the secondary and tertiary sectors are producing 4/5 of the produce, whereas they employ less than half of the people. Why? Just now that I was discussing that 4/5 of the produce is 25% primary से आ रहा है and secondary and tertiary मिला के 75% आ रहा है income. Got it? So that is what we need to understand. Workers in agriculture are not producing as much as they could. Got it? Output agriculture में involvement लोगों का ज़्यादा है लेकिन output ज़्यादा नहीं है. We need to understand and that is what we are going to assess further. आगे हम इसको समझने की कोशिश करेंगे कि 45% people मिलके, I mean 45% of the population is contributing only. 45% of population is contributing only 25%, while the other 55%, try to understand, these are the calculations that you need to explain, other 55% is producing 75%, giving 75%, contributing 75% in the GDP. Got it? We are trying to understand why this is happening. It means that more people are there in agriculture than it is necessary. Jada se jada log. Jahan pe do bhi kaam kar sakte hain, wahan pe 10 people are there working. Got it? So even if what happens is, even if you move few people out, production will not be affected. Workers in the agriculture sector are underemployed. Okay, so 5 people can do some work, but then there are 10 people working on the same field. On that field or on that piece of land, 5 people can easily contribute and do their work, but then 10 people are involved. These extra 5 people are underemployed. उनकी वहाँ ज़रूरत नहीं है. Try to understand what is underemployed. The people are not needed there. They are needed at some other place. But सारे के सारे मिलके वहीं पे एक ही जगह पे काम कर रहे हैं. जैसे now just see again. I told you ना, in economics you have to explain everything with the help of example. For instance, take the case of a small farmer. हाँ, एक छोटे सा farmer की बात करते हैं. She is Lakshmi. Owning about 2 hectares of unirrigated land, dependent only on rain and growing crops like jowar and arar. Haan, Lakshmi hai. Chote matlab, she is a small farmer. To uske paas 2 hectares land hai and khali pani ka, matlab, imagine now, try to understand that 2 hectares of land and no proper water arrangement. Irrigation के लिए the most important thing that is needed is water availability, children. But her work is totally dependent on rain. And what kind of crop she is growing, you can see. Now what happens, children? 5 members are working in the same plot throughout the year. Why? Because they don't have work. Unemployment की condition है यहाँ पे. Everyone is working. Nobody is sitting idle at home. But actual fact is that ki they are not doing the work that is needed. And their labor effort gets divided. Again, meaning just now that we were discussing, there are 5 members in the family. Whatever work is being done on that piece of land can be done by 2 people also. They can also do. So other 3 are just wastage. They are not needed. Okay. और ये नहीं है कि घर में idle बैठे हुए हैं. They are also moving, going to the field and working. So this is the situation of underemployment. People are apparently working, matlab continuously they are working, they know that they are working, they know that they are not unemployed and they are contributing to the income of the family, but in reality they are not doing anything. So what happens is this kind of employment is called as underemployment. It is, just check children, you have to remember this. It is hidden in contrast to someone who does not have a job. किसी के पास काम नहीं है. That is unemployment and is clearly visible as unemployed. Hence, it is also called as disguised unemployment. Got it? There is a very valid question is asked, the difference between unemployed and underemployed. So how do you explain it? That is what underemployed is hidden. Underemployment mein what happens? People are working. You can see them working, but they are not needed there. And unemployed, though, you can clearly see a person who has, who is educated, has cleared the graduation, and have invested a lot of money in education, but still he is unable to earn money. Got it? So that he is, that is that place, he is unemployed, can be clearly visible. Lekin underemployment, disguised, it is also called as underemployment and disguised unemployment are the same. Now, we'll understand it through an example that a landlord is there, his name is Sukram. Pehla to when you explain underemployment, you have to give the example of Lakshmi. Okay? Please mention the example of Lakshmi, through there a lot of things could be clear. Now, we are talking about a landowner, a person who is owning the land, and his name is Sukram. What happens is, he is coming and hiring two members of the family to work. Lakshmi ke ghar mein hi aata hai wo. Sukram comes and asks that two members should go and work on his field. He's a landlord, na? So, if he is a landlord, he might be having lot of land. Kafi sari zameen hogi inke paas. And he is not having people to work on that land. So, what happens is, now Lakshmi's family is able to earn some extra income through wages. Wages means whole day they will be working and at the end of the day they will be getting some payment. So, you do not need 5 people to look after that small plot. Lakshmi is having only 2 hectares, na? And Sukram might be having 10 hectares of land or 50 hectares of land. So these two people who will be working on his land, they move out from that two hectares of land, and it hardly affects the production on their farm. Unke ghar ka kaam waise hi chal raha hai. Means whatever work was happening in the farm is happening in the same manner. So two people are moving to work in factory. Once again, the earning of the family would increase. Got it? Two people are moving in the factory and earning in the factory is increasing. And they would continue to produce as much from their land. Jitna kaam kar rahe the apne land pe, whatever they were producing from their land, that though they will be producing, usme there won't be any compromise or there won't be any changes. तो ये हमने लक्ष्मी का एग्जाम्पल लिया, बट देन देयर आर लैक्स ऑफ फार्मर्स लाइक लक्ष्मी. लक्ष्मी के जैसे बहुत सारे फार्मर्स हैं इंडिया में. दिस वॉज जस्ट वन एग्जाम्पल. सो इफ वी रिमूव लॉट ऑफ पीपल फ्रॉम एग्रीकल्चरल सेक्टर एंड प्रोवाइड देम विद प्रॉपर वर्क, एग्रीकल्चरल सेक्टर इज द प्लेस वेयर वी फाइंड मैक्सिमम अंडर एम्प्लॉयमेंट. Now let me make one thing very clear, children, ki this kind of thing you won't find. This is only prevalent in the primary sector. 2 hectare land mein aap 5 logon ko kaam karte huye dekh rahe ho. But you hardly find any underemployment in primary and secondary sector. It is not primary and secondary, it is secondary and tertiary sectors. Underemployment nahi. Wo to kya karenge ki in primary, in secondary and tertiary sector, what happens? They'll make one person work, do the work of 5 people. 5 logon ka kaam ek aadmi se karayenge taki salary kam deni pade. 5 logon ko rakhenge to 5 logon ki salary deni padegi. But here what they do, underemployment case is very much, you will hardly find any underemployment case in tertiary or the secondary sector. So, what happens, The income of people who take up other work would increase the total family income. Lakshmi's family, 5 people, 2 of them can do the same job and 3 of them are moving out. 3 of them can do the same job jitna wo kaam kar rahe hain and 2 of the people go and start working with Sukhram. तो ये जब काम शुरू हो जाएगा सो यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट हाउ लक्ष्मीज फैमिली इनकम विल इंक्रीज. सो वॉट हैपन्स, अंडर एम्प्लॉयमेंट हैपन्स इन अदर सेक्टर्स ऑल्सो. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, थाउजेंड्स ऑफ कैजुअल वर्कर्स आर देयर इन सर्विस सेक्टर इन अर्बन एरियाज. शहरों में आप देखोगे अभी मजदूरों की कंडीशन आप देख रहे हो इन द टूडे सिनेरियो इफ वी डिस्कस. Their condition is really bad. How they have moved out of their villages and gone to the urban areas. कोई मजदूर का काम कर रहा था, कोई ऑटो चला रहा था, somebody was doing the painting work. Means people were involved in some or the other work. ये सारे casual laborers जो थे, casual workers जो थे, they were involved in the service sector in urban areas. शहरों में, गांव छोड़ के चले गए थे. Now just see what work they were doing. They are employed as painters, plumbers, repair persons and others doing odd jobs. लेकिन इसमें क्या होता है कि thousands of people, here we are talking about thousands of people moving to the urban areas. तो क्या thousands of people will be getting a proper job? No, my dear children, it doesn't happen. Many of them don't find work every day. Similarly, in the street. ठीक है, शहरों में क्या होता है ना, आप सड़कों पे भी लोगों को काम करते हुए देखोगे. वी सी अदर पीपल ऑफ द सर्विस सेक्टर ऑन द स्ट्रीट पुशिंग अ कार्ट और सेलिंग समथिंग. कुछ ना कुछ आप किसी को बेचते हुए देखोगे, कोई बेच रहा है, somebody is selling something, somebody is a vendor. So what happens is this type of environment, they spend the whole day but earn very little. Rickshaw pullers, the laborers, the people who are working at the construction sites, whole day they work and at the end of the day they get only 100 rupees. Kitni jagah to 70-80 rupees hota hai, they hardly earn 70-80 rupees. Then what happens that the people, that these families who are having 3 kids, do ladke hai, ek ladki hai, then what do the parents do? Husband wife are working on the same field and they take the 2 boys also to work on the same field. They are on the construction site. Now husband and wife are earning 80 rupees per day. So 160 ho gaya, do betto ko aur usme laga denge. So 160 plus 160, 320. They will be earning 320 per day. Imagine, but look at the condition of those boys who will be doing work at the construction site. Are we thinking about their education? Are we thinking about their future? No, my dear children. यहाँ से problem शुरू होती है. They are doing this work because they do not have better opportunities. काम करने का मौका नहीं मिल रहा है. And they have come to the city area, they have come to the urban areas, but they are not getting work to do. तो जो भी काम मिलेगा वो काम वो करेंगे. Now just see children, again one activity is here. You can see the table that is given here. The graph is here 2 and 3 and answer the questions of the following. Ignore if data are not available for some years. Now this activity you all have to do. The graph that we have seen, 1972-73 wala there was there, 1973-74 and 2011 and 12 and 13 and 14. So you have to just calculate the GDP. It is very clearly mentioned there. Graph mein calculations kaise karte hain? You might have definitely practiced in maths. Mathematics mein you people have done it. So you can easily see the graph and fill up this table. Now children try to understand that the calculations, these graph based questions are asked in the boards also. So study of the graph and then doing the calculations from these graphs are also very important. The changes that you observe in the primary sector, प्राइमरी सेक्टर में आप जो चेंजेस देख रहे हो इन अ स्पैन ऑफ 40 इयर्स. ऑफ कोर्स चिल्ड्रन, वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इट अ लॉट दैट प्राइमरी सेक्टर द जीडीपी हैज बीन लेस, टर्शियरी सेक्टर हैज बीन मैक्सिमम, बट एम्प्लॉयमेंट हैज बीन मैक्सिमम इन द प्राइमरी सेक्टर टिल डेट. Got it? So you have to choose the correct answer here. Under employment occurs when, abhi ye answer aap isko acche se isme choose karo. They do not want to work, they are working in a lazy manner, are working less than what they are capable of doing, are not paid for their work. So here children, clearly you can understand the third one option. They are working less because they are capable of doing much better. Lakshmi's family, five people were there. All the five people were working. Usme clearly likha hua tha, nobody was sitting idle at home. So you can understand that they want to work, but the capability, their capacity is to work better. Zyada kaam kar sakte hain, but they are not doing that. They are not doing, aisa nahi karna nahi chahte, but they are not getting a chance to do that. Now one very important question is here children, question number 3. Compare and contrast the changes in India with the pattern that was observed for developed countries. What kind of changes between sectors were desired but did not happen in India? ठीक है, primary, secondary and tertiary. So what happens is, first तो आपको compare करना है, उसके बाद contrast the changes in India with the pattern that was observed. Developed countries में. Now here I would like to explain this children. In the primary sector, the maximum people who were involved, if they were trained, अगर इनको train किया जाता for small occupations, गाड़ी चलाना, transport business, starting a self business at home, making a small factories where good is manufactured or anything as such, small handicraft emporiums at the local level, secondary sector mein badh jate log. More of education would have been given here, or the people who are skilled in the secondary sector, if they are given a chance to go to the tertiary sector, to yahan pe employment ki condition theek ho jati, जो कि नहीं थी, विच वॉज नॉट देयर, विच वॉज मिसिंग. इट वॉज लैक ऑफ प्रॉपर एम्प्लॉयमेंट हियर इन दिस सेक्टर. तो आप इसमें अपने आइडियाज दे सकते हो, यू कैन कंपेयर एंड कंट्रास्ट. व्हाई शुड वी बी वरीड अबाउट अंडर एम्प्लॉयमेंट? अंडर एम्प्लॉयमेंट वी हैव टू बी वरीड अबाउट इज people feel that they are employed but they are actually not employed, they are just wasting their energy behind a work, for a work where they are not needed. Skilled people, healthy people are involved in the same work which is not supposed to be done by them. Now one nice topic is here children, please try to understand. Ye yahan pe diya hua hai, ठीक है. वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट डिस्गाइज्ड अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट अंडर एम्प्लॉयमेंट, बट देन द क्वेश्चन अराइजेस हाउ टू क्रिएट मोर एम्प्लॉयमेंट. ज्यादा से ज्यादा को काम कैसे मिलना चाहिए? देयर कंटिन्यूज टू बी कंसिडरेबल अंडर एम्प्लॉयमेंट इन एग्रीकल्चर. सबसे ज्यादा एग्रीकल्चर में अंडर एम्प्लॉयमेंट है. गॉट इट चिल्ड्रन? तो क्या करना चाहिए? There are also people who are not employed at all. Got it? So two types of categories are there, where on one side there is underemployment and on the other side is unemployment. So what can be done? Kya kar sakte hain? Let us look for some of the examples. Wahi abhi we have discussed the case of Lakshmi. So when we discussed the case of Lakshmi, Lakshmi ke ghar mein kya ho raha tha? Panch log the, jahan pe do log kaam kar sakte the, wahan panch log ja rahe the kaam karne ke liye. तो ऑन द 2 hectare प्लॉट ऑफ अनइरिगेटेड लैंड गवर्नमेंट कैन स्पेंड सम मनी और बैंक्स कैन प्रोवाइड अ लोन टू कंस्ट्रक्ट अ वेल फॉर हर फैमिली. बिकॉज यू रिमेंबर, इफ यू रिमेंबर द एग्रीकल्चर बिजनेस दे वर इन्वॉल्व इन, उनका सारा पानी का जो अवेलेबिलिटी था डैट वॉज ओनली थ्रू रेन. हाउ कैन एनी बडी, अभी 2 हेक्टेयर ऑफ लैंड, इसीलिए तो कुछ नहीं वो कर पा रहे थे. दे वेयर अनेबल टू डू एनीथिंग ऑन दैट 2 हेक्टेयर ऑफ लैंड बिकॉज दे डिड नॉट हैव प्रॉपर वाटर अवेलेबिलिटी. तो गवर्नमेंट शुड मेक सम अरेंजमेंट फॉर वाटर अवेलेबिलिटी. अब वो कैसे हो सकता है, कुआं खुदवा सकते हैं, अभी कुआं खुदवाने के लिए भी तो खर्चा लगेगा ना, तो वो पैसा कहाँ से आएगा. बैंक्स कैन गिव अ लोन, दे कैन कंस्ट्रक्ट अ वेल फॉर आवर फैमिली टू इरीगेट द लैंड. उससे क्या होगा, लक्ष्मी विल देन बी एबल टू इरीगेट हर लैंड, 2 हेक्टेयर ऑफ लैंड विच इज़ लेफ्ट अनइरीगेटेड. अभी तक जो 2 हेक्टेयर ऑफ लैंड है वहाँ पे कुछ नहीं हो रहा है, हो सकता है थोड़ा बहुत सब्जी उब्जी उगा लेते होंगे या कुछ इस तरह का. एंड दे कैन टेक अप अ सेकेंड क्रॉप, पहला जो भी क्रॉप कर रहे हैं, आई टोल्ड यू ना, दे माइट बी ग्रोइंग सम वेजिटेबल्स. मेनी ऑफ द पीपल दे ग्रो इन द अर्बन एरियाज में, मंदिर उंदिर होता है तो फूल उगाने लगते हैं, फूलों का बिजनेस करते हैं, तो बट इनकम इज नॉट दैट मच ना. नाउ वॉट दे कैन डू इफ वाटर अवेलेबिलिटी इज प्रॉपर, अगर अच्छे से उनको अपने खेत के लिए पानी मिल जाए तो दे कैन ग्रो अ सेकेंड क्रॉप. एंड वॉट इज दैट सेकेंड क्रॉप चिल्ड्रन, इट इज वेरी वेल क्लियरली गिवन ईयर, व्हीट. व्हीट वेन कैन दे ग्रो, ड्यूरिंग द राबी सीजन, यू नो राबी एंड खरीफ ना. हाँ, ज्योग्राफी में यू हैव ऑलरेडी रेड अबाउट राबी एंड खरीफ. सो ड्यूरिंग द राबी सीजन यू दे कैन ग्रो व्हीट. अभी सोचो अगर गेहूं की खेती वो करते हैं तो ऑब्वियसली द इनकम विल इंक्रीज ना. सो लेट अस सपोज दैट 1 हेक्टेयर व्हीट कैन प्रोवाइड एम्प्लॉयमेंट टू 2 पीपल फॉर 50 डेज. अंडर एम्प्लॉयमेंट की प्रॉब्लम यहाँ पे चिल्ड्रन यू कैन सी हाउ इट इज बीइंग सॉल्वड, प्रॉब्लम को वो दूर कर रहे हैं. सो व्हीट जो गेहूं की खेती वो कर रहे हैं तो उसमें 2 पीपल आर इन्वॉल्व फॉर 50 डेज. 50 दिन तक वो काम करेंगे, 50 डेज तक क्या क्या काम करेंगे देखो, इट इज मेंशन्ड हियर. यू विल बी वंडरिंग एक्चुअली व्हाट वर्क दे विल बी डूइंग. सो दे विल बी सोइंग सीड्स, दे विल बी वाटरिंग द प्लांट्स, दे विल बी यूजिंग द फर्टिलाइजर्स. गॉट इट. हार्वेस्टिंग एप्लीकेशन, फर्टिलाइजर एप्लीकेशन एंड हार्वेस्टिंग, इतना सारा काम है ना. ग्रोइंग वीट इज नॉट एन ईजी टास्क, इट्स अ टफ टास्क माई डियर चिल्ड्रेन. एंड अगेन आई एम टेलिंग यू, यू माइट बी हैविंग योर रूट्स इन द विलेजेस, तो आपने देखा होगा गेहूं की खेती कैसे होती है और कितनी मेहनत लगती है. सो इफ दीज पीपल आर गेटिंग, अभी यहाँ पे ओनली वन थिंग गवर्नमेंट हैज टू डू, गवर्नमेंट हैव टू प्रोवाइड देम विथ सम मनी. चलो मनी नहीं भी प्रोवाइड करते हैं, दे कैन गेट द अरेंजमेंट डन जहाँ पे कि उनके खेत के आसपास कहीं कुआं खुदवा दें, एक पंप सेट दे दें, तो उनके खेत में पानी की कमी नहीं होगी. राइट नाउ व्हाई देयर 2 हेक्टेयर ऑफ लैंड इज लेफ्ट फैलो, फालतू क्यों पड़ा हुआ है, बिकॉज दे आर नॉट गेटिंग प्रॉपर वाटर रेन्स. दे आर डिपेंडिंग फॉर ऑन रेन फॉर वाटरिंग द प्लांट्स, इमेजिन. सो 2 more members of the family can be employed in her own field. अभी इसमें आगे और हम क्या कर सकते हैं, जस्ट सी द वेज एंड मेथड्स. नाउ सपोज अ न्यू डैम इज कंस्ट्रक्टेड, आसपास कहीं डैम अगर कंस्ट्रक्ट हो रहा है तो वहां से एक कनाल खुदाई कर सकते हैं, नहर. यू अंडरस्टैंड कनाल ना, पानी इज अवेलेबल इन अबंडेंस. जो डैम्स होते हैं, जो बांध बनता है, वहाँ पे आसपास में पानी अवेलेबिलिटी बहुत अच्छी होती है. सो इफ़ द फार्मर्स वांट टू यूटिलाइज द वाटर, वो अगर पानी चाहते हैं तो वहाँ से एक कनाल खोद के एक नहर बना के अपने खेत तक पानी ला सकते हैं. सो यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड हाउ गुड इट वुड बी फॉर देम, एंड खाली नॉट ओनली फॉर लक्ष्मी, उसके आसपास की जितनी भी जमीन होगी सबको पानी मिलने लगेगा. सो This could lead to a lot of employment generation. Children, our major problem was disguised unemployment. हमने जहाँ पे ये टॉपिक शुरू किया था, that was disguised unemployment. Disguised unemployment की प्रॉब्लम यहाँ पे सॉल्व होती है. 5 लोग जो फालतू का बैठे थे, फालतू का काम कर रहे थे. Children, we couldn't say कि वो फालतू बैठे थे. All the 5 people were working. वो इट वॉज क्लियरली मैंशन कि दे वेर नॉट लेजी पीपल सिटिंग एट होम. बट उनको पता नहीं था कि वो कुछ काम नहीं कर रहे हैं. दे कैन डू समथिंग समथिंग दैट इज कंस्ट्रक्टिव. सो विद इन द एग्रीकल्चरल सेक्टर इट्स सेल्फ रिड्यूसिंग द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ अंडर एम्प्लॉयमेंट. एग्रीकल्चर में ही वो काम करते दे वुड हैव बीन इन्वॉल्व देयर ओनली एंड द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ अंडर एम्प्लॉयमेंट वुड हैव बीन सॉल्व इजली. गॉट इट चिल्ड्रन? सो दिस वॉज द प्लेस वेयर एम्प्लॉयमेंट जनरेशन हैड हैपेंड. कहाँ पे? प्लीज ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड. अभी वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग ऑफ सेकेंडरी एंड टर्शरी, वी आर टॉकिंग ऑफ प्राइमरी सेक्टर. गॉट इट? सेकेंडरी और टर्शरी पे तो अभी हम पहुँचे ही नहीं हैं. प्राइमरी सेक्टर की जो अंडर एम्प्लॉयमेंट की प्रॉब्लम थी वो यहाँ पे सॉल्व हो जाती. सो जस्ट रिवाइज इट चिल्ड्रन. इन केस यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन गेट इट क्लियर विथ मी ऑन द ऑनलाइन सेशन. सो थैंक यू चिल्ड्रन एंड ऑल द बेस्ट टू यू.